Chris Maylett for BBTV. We're over at the Everton Red Triangle Boxing Club in Liverpool. I'm very pleased to say I'm joined by unbeaten prospect Harry Woods. Yeah, great to see you, Harry.
Good to see you.
Another fight coming up this Saturday night. It's coming around quick, hasn't it?
Yeah, nah, they're coming here. They're coming thick and fast, like. Exactly what I want, to be honest. Staying nice and busy, so yeah, looking forward to Saturday night.
Lewis Van Pooch, you fought in your last fight.
Yeah, he'd
scored a stoppage in his fight before. He's a really good operator. How did you feel in there with him on the night, and how do you think you performed in that fight?
Yeah, I thought there's obviously areas that I've watched it back. There's obviously areas I've looked to improve next time, and just that I've worked on in the gym. But I was fairly happy with me. I thought I did better than my debut. Sort of remain like quite composed and that, stuck behind my jab, stuck to listen to Paul in the corner, just stuck to my boxing. So, as I say, he is quite dangerous. I think he has a knockout in his fight before me. Like, so, yeah, I was just staying wary of like his backhand, just trying to time a few counters and that. But yeah, as I say, just stuck to my boxing nearly, listen to Paul.
Interesting, you said you made your debut. Do you feel like from your debut in that fight you'd made a big progression even in that short time?
Yeah.
Getting that debut out of the way and getting on the...
Definitely. Well, I learned a lot on my debut. I got in, it was a last minute opponent and it was a southpaw in the end. So I had like a different problems in my debut compared to my second fight with Lewis Van Pot. Like, so, they're exactly the type of fight that I need to be progressing in my career. Like, so, but since my debut, I feel like in the gym every day with Paul, learning all the time. Literally every day is just coming here to learn, get better and improve. So I feel like things are coming together.
And you love that, do you? You're soaking it up.
Yeah.
You all seem like it. You're all that good student. Paul's a great teacher. You can see that.
Yeah.
You're all coming through together and it's Do you feel that buzz about it and that? You're just soaking it all up?
Yeah, definitely. We're all on the same page looking to progress and that. So it's a good atmosphere in the gym and everything. And obviously listening to Paul, literally, he's got so much knowledge to give us and he's got a great way of teaching us, so we're just all learning off Paul as much as we can, like, so it's brilliant.
Now you've boxed all your life from a kid, the amateurs,
you had
a good amateur career.
Back
before we talk about what you did in the amateurs, how did it first come into your life, boxing, to realise that something you wanted to dedicate your life to?
Originally when I first started, I think my granddad's always been nearly interested in boxing, like he's never done it himself, but he's always had a real big interest in it. And then I think I just went down to Kirby ABC with two of my mates in school, and I think I was around 11, something like that. And then a couple of my mates at the time, they only went a few times, and I've been doing it like over 10 years later, like, so I don't know, not sure, I've just always, I've always like just loved it, so like I've loved everything about it, so.
Did you just have a knack for it when you went in there? Was it an instant?
Nah, to be honest, starting off, I weren't great starting off. I think I lost maybe 8 of my first 10 as a kid, something like that, so I weren't like, it never clicked straight away, but I think I always like, I could started feeling myself getting better and stuff like that when I was around 13 maybe, got a few wins, and then it's just always, I just loved it, I loved the fighting sides of it and everything about it, so.
I suppose, you know, losing 8 of your first 10 fights, I might have put a lot of kids off.
I just wanted to accept that it weren't going to work out, and then obviously I'm very thankful that I have stuck to it over the years, and I'm trying to make a career out of it now, so yeah, definitely.
Turned it around and winning.
Yeah.
When you did start winning, you carried on winning and you did well through the amateurs, just took us back to your career.
Yeah, so as a junior and as a schoolboy and junior, I always ended up getting to like the quarters, semis, the championships. I'd like, don't want to say I had bad decisions and that, but I always felt like, I was always in close fights and stuff. But and then as I got to a senior, I had a little bit of a break. Sorry, after my first fracture my eye socket when I was, I think, in my first senior fight. So I had a little break from boxing around that time. And I came back a year later at 81 kilos and amateur, shot light heavyweight, and then I had like a bit of a good run, got on the England squad, boxed with England a few times, and then ended up like, I think I boxed with England four times in total as a senior, and then got to the semis, the ABAs, lost on a split decision to George Crotty that year, I think it was 2017 that will have been, so yeah. That's the furthest I got in the ABAs, the semi-finals, didn't it? Which was, I was a little bit gutted about losing up there, but so that was basically my amateur career.
And at what point in your amateur career or after you, would you focus on turning pro? Did you know you was always going to be a pro?
I always had it in my head, when I first started, but at a very young age, like I wanted a career in this, like, I do love boxing and I always wanted to follow, take this as far as I can go, so I always had in my head I wanted to turn pro, and then I got to 23 and it was defo time to turn over, really haven't looked back since, like coming nearly happy I came with Paul. I couldn't be in a better place to be learning and developing as a boxer,
And these are all coming through now. I was saying to the other lads, it's like the new generation of you're part of the new generation of Liverpool.
Yeah.
Like new pro boxers coming through, representing the city in the coming years. You're following on from some great fighters who have come from this, great fighting city. Are you aware of that? That you're part of that now, and in the future you could be the name, the next.
I haven't thought of it like that, to be honest. I just take literally each fight as it comes, each day as it comes in the gym with Paul, and just as I say, every session I just want to like learn as much as I can and get better all the time, so I haven't thought that way, so to speak.
That's just me.
But
you must have ambitions and dreams of or steps.
Definitely.
to a final, chapter way that you want to go. And what are they?
Obviously every boxer, there's the British title, has got so much history and stuff like that, that'd be something that every boxer in my position would definitely look to aim for. But I'm not putting any pressure on it, and I just want to take it literally as far as I can go, and put myself in the best place where I feel like I can develop and do that at everything at Triangle, just literally so I can have a career and look back on it and know I've took it as far as I can go and put everything into it, that's what I want to have a career like.
You said that about
you're
coming through together in here, it appears like a real good camaraderie in there, young pros as well. And Paul Stevenson, your coach, is behind all that, and champions that and glues it all together.
Yeah.
What is it? Explain that buzz at the moment of how you all coming through together. Paul's, behind you, do you feel you're on this kind of a crest of a wave at the moment?
Yeah, definitely. We're all getting on really well in the gym. We're all close on that. And obviously, Paul. Such a good trainer, as I say, and then you come to the gym and just trying to get the most out of them, we're all just trying to get the most out of ourselves, so we're all on the same page, really, so it's really good.
Saturday night, actually seems to come round quick again.
Fast,
we're in the final week now. How are you feeling, sort of final week of fighting? I just can't wait for Saturday night.
Wait for Saturday night, just the excitement more than anything else, just looking forward to getting there and there. As I say, I feel like since even my last fight, I feel like I've came on again, so I just want to go out and put on a show,
shows what you can do again.
Definitely.
I'm really looking forward to seeing you again out there, and I wish you all the best going forward.
Thanks, Sean.
Absolutely. Anyone wants any tickets these final few days, we'll put your social media handle on the screen, so how can you get hold of it?
Show me Instagram's HWoods_. I think Twitter's Harry16Woods, and then my Facebook's just Harry Woods.
Get down there.
Greenbank
Leisure Centre. This Saturday night. Harry Woods in action. It's great to see you, mate. Wish you all the best.
Thanks very much. Thanks, Sean. Thank you. Thanks, Sean.